Hello friends, in this video we will see what is single dimensional motion. Single dimensional motion is if object move from x1 position to x2 and in one direction, this is called a single dimensional motion. An object moving along a straight line is one dimensional motion. So x1 is the starting position, x2 is ending position in the straight line. Suppose there is a position in road x1 and x2, the object cover from x1 to x2, this is single line, one dimensional motion. So object A is moving from position x1 to x2 in a straight line on reaching on point x2 the distance. So the object A cover distance is x2 minus x1. So x2 minus x1 is the distance that is covered by object A, and which time it is covered, it is calculated by the static time and the ending time. If object starts at time t1 and reach on position x2 at t2, the time taken by object A is t2 minus t1. If start at 1 o'clock and reach at 2 o'clock, then the time is 1 hour. So this is time taken is by t2 minus t1. Now velocity, this is in, we are taking its time as a scalar, not a vector. In a scalar, there is a direction is doesn't matter. In vector, if object A moving in x direction, this is positive direction. If it moving in minus x direction, this is negative direction. But in the scalar, there is a doesn't matter of direction. So the velocity. Velocity is the distance covered by object in time. In this, object A cover distance x2 minus x1 in time t2 minus t1. So velocity v is x2 minus x1 upon t2 minus t1. So in a scalar format, the difference between distance or distance by the difference between time is the velocity. Now next is acceleration. This is the main tracing distance, velocity and acceleration in the single dimensional motion. Acceleration is the rate of change of velocity with time. So if object A has the time at time t1 velocity v1 and at the time t2 velocity v2, then the acceleration is v2 minus v1 upon t2 minus t1. So this is the acceleration of object. So we will see distance, velocity and acceleration in this video. Next video we will see some other feature of physics that we'll use in our programming in physical gaming and other things too. Thanks.